Hi, welcome to another class of Qigong, Tai Chi, and meditation for a healthy spine. So we'll focus on the spine today. Stand with your feet parallel, shoulder width apart. Charge the soles of the feet, open the spine, open the chest. Like a big smile on your chest. Put your hands behind your back. You can grab the wrists, the forearms, or the elbows. 80% effort if you want to do. Less is more, where it's comfortable. Relax your shoulders. Lengthen the neck. Deep breathing in and out through the nose. Work the lungs. So find out what is your 100%. So first take a breath, 100%. So that's your 100. Now, from now on, just take 90, 85, 90%. Rotate the hips counterclockwise. The tongue touch the roof of the mouth. Visualize a healing energy ball 2 inches below the navel in the center of the body. So you move your mind down to the center and you visualize a healing energy ball. If you can close your eyes and you feel safe, close your eyes. If you can't close your eyes because you feel unstable, you can hold on to something. Then you can close your eyes because the experience is stronger when you close your eyes. Especially the lower energy visualization. Also putting the mind, differentiating between left and right. So how does your left hip compare to your right hip along the circle? What about the ankles, the lower back, the neck? No weight on the toes. Lift the toes off the ground and spread them. Change direction, clockwise, change the grip behind your back. Try to go 3-4 circles, inhalation. And 3 or 4 circles, exhalation. Go to real small circles, like the size of a dime. Your mind between the soles of the feet and the floor, push on the small circle. Some of you may feel heat builds up there. The more you keep the mind there, the stronger the heat gets. That's what the Chinese call qi, because your mind is there and the friction is there. It creates that warmth. And then you take that warmth and spread it up into the bones, into the lower energy center. Then go to large circles. Feel a gentle massage to your lower back, hamstring, quads, the ankle area. Everything stretches. This is dynamic stretching versus static. Circle helps stretch the muscles around the hips, the groin, the spine. You want to free the soft tissue from around the vertebrates and the areas around the joints, like and the muscles that move into the spine from the legs and from the upper body and the neck. And take all that stress and tension and off the spine by stretching the soft tissue. Add the breath from the inside out. The ribs expand. The smooth muscles stretch. All of it is connected to your spine. At the same time, remember there's no end to the lengthening of the spine upwards. Always feel the spine moving up, up, like a string from the top of the head into the heaven. The spine is the string and the head is the balloon. So that's another metaphor. And the balloon is helium and it just moves up and help the spine move up. We'll go into the windmill. The windmill helps stretch again the rotation muscles around the spine. But there's other benefits here. This is also a balance exercise, letting go the arms and tapping the internal organs. So first I tap the spleen and kidney, liver, kidney. The liver on the right side underneath the floating ribs, the spleen under the left, kidneys in the back. If you tap wherever it's the most sensitive, that's where your kidneys are. So the back hand touches the right kidney, the left touches the spleen. When you turn to the right, the left touches the liver, the right touches the kidney, the left kidney. That's liver, kidney, spleen, kidney. Liver, kidney, spleen, kidney. Rotate from the spine, from the lower energy center. Inhale when your arms are open. Exhale when you tap. Even though my body is turning, my neck, I keep looking forward. So the neck gets a nice stretch as well. Especially if you turn your body all, your shoulders pointing to the camera. Can if it's you can go all the way to one leg and the other leg comes up, the heel comes off the ground. If not, you can stay with both legs on the ground and turn, but you won't turn as much, of course. By lifting the leg, it allows you to turn much further. The arms are loose. Only at the last second, you bend the elbows and try to be really precise. The center of the palm touches the liver, and the center of the back palm touches the kidney. Some people like to tap, some people like to touch. Either way, you're nourishing the internal organs, you're removing stagnation through the tapping. Your palm gets nice and warm. Now divide the lungs into three parts. Bottom, middle, and top. And we're going to tap the bottom parts of the lungs. When you turn like this, you stretch the rotating muscles around. Every vertebra has three groups of muscles. Lateral, forward and backward, and rotation. So here we're stretching the rotation muscles throughout the whole spine and the neck. Try to fit your fingers right between the ribs. Then go to the middle lungs. And go to the top. Good. Then tap the kidneys. Try to open the chest, shoulders back, open the spine, and look up to the ceiling. Deep breathing in and out through the nose. Relax your shoulders. If you can't reach with both hands, so tap with one hand And then switch and tap with the other. Then circle, warm the kidneys, circle the right hand to the outside and the left to the out towards the outside. So the circle right hand is clockwise, if you look from your where you're at, and left is counterclockwise. Then with your back to the wall, or you can also do that sitting on the chair. You don't have to touch the wall, but the sacrum touch the wall, the back of the shoulders touch the wall, the palms, the front of the palm touch the wall, and the head goes against the wall. Back of the head. Deep breathing in and out through the nose, like you're lying on your back on the beach. If you know that you have a sensitive neck, you don't have to bring your head back to the wall. Try to just keep it straight, relax the muscles around the neck, and feel the opening upward through the whole spine. Charge the soles of the feet. Like your spine is like a tree or an ivy climbing up the wall. Relax your shoulders. Deep breathing, move the abdomen, the back muscles in on the inhalation and out on the exhalation. Inhale, you look up to the ceiling. Exhale, tuck your chin into your collarbone. But don't lose the sacrum and the back of the shoulder blades still touch the wall and the palms. Inhale, up. Exhale, tuck your chin. If you can't tuck your chin all the way to the collarbone, just go halfway. Feel the neck muscles stretching gently. Inhale. And exhale. In. Out. Feel the difference between the left side of the neck and the right side, which side is tighter. So that tightness puts a strain on your spine, it pulls it to the muscles tense in certain areas and pull it to different directions. And that's how it breaks alignment. And you can lead to pain, ache, chronic conditions. You have to strive to always find what is correct alignment with my spine and how do I achieve it. Then move a little bit from the wall, walk a little bit, loosen up your shoulders, your neck, your back. Go back to the near the wall. Inhale, move your arms and try to touch the wall behind you with the back parts of the palms. If you can't do your arms straight, you feel it's a strain in your spine, your neck. So you go into the Y, or you go into a T, or you go into a W. Either way, you want to, on the way down, you want the sacrum and the shoulder blades to touch the wall and the palms. Tuck the chin in like what we did before. Inhale, you leave the wall with your sacrum. You leave the wall with the shoulder blades. And you lift your arms. And if you can, if your neck is healthy, you touch the wall with the back parts of the neck, of the head. And again, be careful, don't strain anything. Inhale. Exhale. So remember, so when you're here, my sacrum, my shoulder blades, my palm touch the wall, my chin tucked in. Then I move away from the wall with my sacrum. I arch the spine up and around and back. I lift my arms. So of course, the further away you move from the wall, the harder it is. I also call this shake the carpet or back bends, like gentle back bends. The spine goes back and the spine moves forward. You massage the vertebrae, you stretch the soft tissue around the spine, you stretch the arms, the neck. Free the skeleton from being a prisoner of the soft tissue. Now add the breath if you forgot. So try to coordinate that when you finish the movement, you finish the inhalation. Ready? And when you finish the movement down, you finish the exhalation. In and out. When you lift your arms, either to the I, the Y, the T, or the W, stretch through the fingers, stretch through the arms. Try to keep your arm nice and straight. Open the chest. And one, the right hand goes up, the left stays, like up, down, then the left goes up, down. Feel now the sensation in the lungs when the right goes up and you inhale, then the left lung. Now, as one goes up, so start from here, one up, one down. One goes down, the other one goes up. Exhale. From here, inhale. Exhale. Inhale. If you're going from the T, let's see. So what are you doing? You're going from here, one here, and then you go. Stand with your feet parallel. Put your hands, the middle finger touches the middle line. Rock from the ball of the foot to the heels. But the soles of the feet stay flat. Then the ball of foot doesn't come off the ground and the heel don't come off the ground. When I move to my heels, I bend my knees and I arch the spine. This is called stretch the bones, the spine and the chest. When I go to the ball of the foot, I straighten my legs, my knees, and I open the chest, open the spine, and look up. The middle finger touch the center line, the side center line of your legs. Inhale when you go to the ball of the foot and open the spine. Exhale when you go to your heels and curve the spine and the chest. Then, when you go to the ball of the foot, bring your hands back. Pretend like there's a table behind you and you want to lift your weight off the table. So tense the palms so the fingers are pointing straight forward. When you go to your heels, lift the arms up. Crane, balancing on a bamboo after a long flight. And now we're going to change the breath. So inhale when you go to your heels and curve the spine and bring your arms up. Exhale when you go to the ball of the foot and open the spine, chest. Inhale. Feel now how the air moves to the back parts of the lungs. So it's not only that we stretch the muscle through movements around the spine, we also from the inside out. I like that one, like the Incredible Hulk. So when you inhale and stretch the bows, feel how you feel the back and you want to rip the shirt with your expansion of the lungs in the back. You can see how all that is all around the spine, stretching the muscles, massaging them, opening the ligaments, freeing the neck, the shoulders, the spine, the lower back, the middle back, the arms, the soles of the feet gets a nice massage. Every part in the soles of the feet correspond to different parts of your body. So continuing shifting weight, massaging the soles of the feet. Pretend like you're standing on a bamboo, and the bamboo moves back, and that's when you go to your heels, and your wings, your crane, moves forward. The bamboo moves forward, your weight is on the ball of the foot, and your wings move back. You're balancing the motion of the bamboo in the wind with your wings. So close your eyes and become the crane sitting on a bamboo. After a long flight, the wind is blowing. When your arms are up, put all five fingers together and point the fingers down into the earth. When your arms are back, spread the fingers. You can do the Tai Chi hand form here. Middle finger slightly forward, thumb and pinky slightly back. This is like acupuncture in motion. Certain muscle tense here all along the body. And then you move up, they release. So the energy and the blood and the deep breathing, the oxygen, everything rushes everywhere, nourishes everything. And then here again, certain groups of muscle tense around meridians, energy channels, blood vessels, and up, release. Inhale and exhale. So we want to have in one exercise and everything we do, body. So the body, all the stuff, roll, rock on the soles of the feet, don't go too far. Lift the toes off the ground. Bend the knees, straighten the knees. Open the spine, open the chest, relax the shoulders, lengthen the neck, and on and on and on. Then the breath. You want to coordinate it so when you finish the inhalation, you got to here, and exhalation, you finish it, you get to here. The mind, third, you want to put your mind in the body and in the breath. The energy, you want to visualize the healing energy ball 2 inches below the navel. So now we have body, breath, mind, and energy. But sometimes, if you do the spirit, so you don't have to visualize so much the lower energy center because the spirit also evokes the energetic system. So you can just be the crane, do the crane eyes looking, standing on the bamboo. That sometimes creates also the energy, but it's not to say that you can be the crane on the bamboo and still visualize the lower energy center. I visualize it like the sun. So I'm the crane on the bamboo in the sunset. Then we want to add the twisting. So that was forward and backward. And I will add with the same motion also a twist. So this time, one hand goes forward, one goes back. The head goes with the trunk. And then when you get to here, you look back. One hand, pretend there's a table, you want to lift yourself. The other one, the beak of the crane. Come to the center, both reach the center at the same time. Inhale as the arm go up. Exhale when you come down. Inhale. Exhale. Nice and slow. This is also a standing, moving meditation. So you want to put yourself into the brainwave between awake and asleep, like you're almost falling asleep, but you're not. Brain caresses us forward and backward. Strikes. Because Tai Chi is also a martial art. When you make the hand go with the beak, that's usually a strike with the bone right here. That's a strong bone. And when you bring your hands back this way, you grab something and you pull it. So it's a strike and a pull. If you visualize that you're striking and pulling, it changes the feeling through the motion versus before. It's different. When you caress, it's a different than strike and pull. Imagine you're holding somebody's wrist and you're pulling it backward. And at the same time, you're striking with the back part of the wrist. So sometimes putting the martial intention, you can feel it's a different energy. Okay, then go to the edge of the chair, or you can still be in the horse stance. So we did vertebrates forward, backward. We did rotation, and now we want to do some lateral. Spider climbs the wall. Left hand, so first left hand up, palm forward, right hand pointing down, palm forward. The left fingers come to the center line and it goes down and sideways. The bottom one also goes to the center line and goes up and rotates. Then both together. Inhale as one go up, as one goes up and one goes down, inhale. Feel the right lung fills up and feel the lateral muscles stretching. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. In. Out. When the arms go up, feel up, up, straight, straight, straight. Point up through the fingers, straight the arm. Same when it goes down. Visualize you shooting five energy beams from your fingers into the sky and five energy beams into deep into the earth. Visualize your lower energy center. See, you're twisting, opening, Right ribs, straight line if you can from the pinky all the way to your hip. And change. Climb, 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 climb. Spider climbs the wall. Don't forget, there's a tendency when you up the hands up here, you forget the one in the bottom. Both equal mind in both, 50-50. And go, everybody sit at the edge of the chair. Make put one hand on top of the other, line up with your lower energy center. Deep breathing in and out through the nose. Close your eyes. Any thoughts coming to your mind, lead them into the breath. Don't worry about the visualization. Don't move the abdomen, the back muscles in and out. Just keep your spine nice and straight. Focus on the breath. It's called Zen Mind. Any thoughts coming to your mind, lead them into the breath. And mind for the spine. You can go with your mind and dissolve around the vertebrates, relax that, and then you feel you can open more. Thank you very much. Happy stretching, deep breathing, empty your mind, and invoke your spirit. Bye.